So we're going to do a creamy carbonara. The sauce is actually made out of squash and cashew nuts and lemon and things like that.
Okay.
And then we do pasta, so I normally use a brown rice pasta, but we can do courgette if you prefer.
What would you like us to do?
Okay, so Holly, do you want to do the spiralizing?
Yes, I am very excited about this. I've got a handheld one, which is not very good. So how do you use this beast?
Okay, so this, you literally just... like this, and it should.
Like, whoa.
Yeah, come out like that. Okay, so I'll let you do that.
So you push it in.
Yeah, and then just go round.
Oh my gosh, that's the most exciting thing ever! And you can spiralise anything, potatoes,
but you need to then cook them, sweet potatoes, you know, beetroot, cucumber,
I'm never going to stop doing this. Everything's going through here.
Well, you've got another two to do.
Hold everything down.
Amazing. Okay, good. And then do you want to make the sauce?
Okay.
So we need to put water and some lemon juice
into a blender. Right, so how much lemon juice? This lemon juice? So
that's about, the juice of one lemon.
One lemon.
So I'm going to chuck that in.
How much water?
About 200 millilitres.
Got it.
Amazing. And it's easier to put your liquids in first, just blend a bit better.
Right.
And then we want about 3 teaspoons of tamari.
Tamari?
And this is basically a gluten-free soy sauce.
Okay.
And then you just take that. And you've got
what's the sausage in the middle?
Yeah, you've got a weird. My dog loves this. It's like his best thing.
Does your dog not like bones? Is your dog not
eating meat as well? No, he does as well, but secretly loves a carrot as well.
Oh.
And then, so our next ingredient is nutritional yeast, which is a kind of deactivated yeast, looks like fish food, but gives a nice kind of cheesy flavour.
How many of those?
2. If you don't have this, you can leave it out, or you can find it kind of online or at a health food shop.
It really does look like fish food.
It really does look like fish food. It's not particularly.
And is it like a cheesy taste?
It tastes cheesy, exactly. And then you want to put in our squash, which has been ready steamed for us.
Right.
Splash.
And then cashews, which have been soaked for us.
Soaked in?
Just in water, just to soften them for a couple of hours, sort of 2-3 hours.
All of them?
Yeah, check them all in. And then some salt.
Just a pinch?
Yeah, a little bit of salt. And then quite a lot of pepper.
How did you learn to do all this stuff? Because I would never think about putting nuts in a carbonara. Like to make that creamy, saucy stuff.
Do you know what, honestly, I started getting into all of this about 4 years ago. I was really ill, and I was at home. I just had so much time, and I didn't cook beforehand, so I was quite...
Oh, really?
And I was always quite creative, so I just had a lot of kind of... I was like, we'll just throw this and throw that. I mean, there were things that went so wrong. The first time I used a food processor, I didn't take the plastic off the blade.
And I made
these brownies. I'm so thrilled.
Oh.
And then gave them someone to throw the plastic.
How much do you want this? Smooth,
smooth? Smooth, smooth, yeah. I think this one holds it on if you do this better. Oh.
Right, there
fun.
You go.
Okay, amazing.
Right, are we done with that?
So yeah, so then we can bring it over here. Oh, I think there's a...
I don't actually know how to get this thing.
This.
I can do that, but I don't know how to get this off.
There you go.
Yeah, but how do you get that off?
Oh, I see, I think lift it.
Okay. Oh, it's just a lift. Okay.
Not as complicated as it looks.
Okay.
Okay.
Yeah,
cool.
What am I doing with this?
So now we're going to go over here and then hold that for one sec. So we need to heat. So we've got garlic and mushrooms cooking in here, which smells really good, and the garlic's added kind of nice, substantial texture. Mm. And we're going to wilt a bit of spinach in there, if you want to check this
all
in.
It?
Yeah.
Okay.
So that would just take a minute or two to wilt.
Okay.
And then once that's soft, we can mix all together. So we've got peas. When I make the pasta, I normally make the peas in the water, but we can choose to use Holly's courgette or pasta.
Yeah.
So we'll use Holly's courgette.
Are you still going? Look how much you've made!
I know, look how much comes from 3 courgettes. It's amazing.
Look at what I did! Look how good it is! It's like the magic porridge pot, isn't it? When it just all comes from
giving.
There you go. I'm going to try butternut. Can you do it with butternut squash?
Yes. And sweet potatoes, really nice, normal potato as well.
We've lost you for the show now, haven't we? It's all about spiralising. Can you make chips out of spiralised?
Yeah, they do have
like spiral chips.
But they do a bigger... You can change the blade to be the thicker one, and then I think it would be quite... You can make noodles. Potato noodles are really good. You know, if you do a kind of udon noodle dish, do potato noodles and then cook them for kind of 10 minutes.
How do I get this in there?
Can you say udon noodle, then?
udon noodles. You know, like a dish like that. You can swap it.
Sound like an ambulance.
Okay, so that's looking really good.
Yeah.
So we can add our peas.
Yeah.
And then we're going to use the courgette. So we can add that, and then do you want to pour your sauce in?
All of it?
All of it. Chuck it in.
What's sort of a thick soup?
It's like a thick soup, yeah.
I have no idea what that's going to taste like.
Hopefully you like it.
I hope I like it too.
And then we can put the courgette.
How long do they have? There's all this.
So you don't want
to
cook the courgette for very long. You just want to, you know, stir it up and gently warm it. Otherwise, it goes a bit soggy if you cook it for more than a couple of minutes.
I really want to know what Gino De Campo would be thinking right now.
Blasphemy.
He's going to be thinking, what?
But it's nice, you know, so often with healthy food, everyone just assumes it's salads and, yeah, like, really light and, like, never very comforting. And, you know, we live in England.
Would so you normally cold. Put this much in? Is it just because this is the amount that you made? Because that
but
seems quite a lot.
It does go down quite a lot.
Look at those.
I know.
Look at that.
So now what do you do?
Okay, sometimes with the courgette it's a bit easier if you cut it
first.
That's really
nice.
Because they do go on.
Oh my gosh.
Are you joking? Can you imagine all of these professional chefs looking at what I've done to this plate?
Oh, it's
there you go.
Okay.
Hang on a minute, let's just make this slightly more presentable.
It's really nice. Beautiful. It doesn't taste anything like... I can't taste butternut squash at all.
Make sure you get some mushrooms and things in there as well.
It really doesn't taste like butternut squash. That's so bizarre. Try it. What do you think?
Oh, that's lovely.
It's really nice, isn't it?
Mm.